Introduction to Carpentry. Carpentry is an age-old trade yet, but there is still a high demand worldwide for skilled carpenters. The trade offers a carpenter many opportunities for professional growth. A modern-day carpenter's work goes well beyond working on residential projects. What do you understand by the term carpentry? Carpentry is the work of making or fixing wooden objects or wooden parts of building. The work done by a carpenter. Carpenters traditionally worked with natural wood and did the rougher work such as framing, but today many other materials are also used. Carpentry is a skilled trade in which the primary work performed is the cutting, shaping and installation of building material during the construction. Key lesson from carpentry: how to use tools and equipments, safety measures and maintenance, what type of a primary material carpenter use, including lumber, proper rough in framing methods and appropriate exterior and interior finishes. Now, let us look at what type of a tools used for carpentry. The carpentry tools that need to purchase in order to build most of the projects are listed below. Measuring tape. It is a common measuring tool and it is designed to allow for a measure for great length to be easily carried in pocket or toolkit and permit one to measure around curves or corners. Power tool. A power tool is a tool that is actuated by an additional power source and mechanism other than the manual labor used with hand tools. Squares. Carpentry squares are very essential carpentry tool. It is an important tool for laying out stair stringers and for framing roofs. Hand tools are also very essential equipment for carpentry. Hammer. Hammers are generally used to break up material. They are available in a variety of weights and length depending on the purpose. Heavier hammers are designed for jobs like framing, decking and roofing, while smaller hammers are used for trim and finish. Levels. It is considered to be an essential tool in woodworking and building projects of many types. The carpenter level is utilized to verify the alignment of various surfaces during the construction process. Moving further, let us study the green building principles for carpentry. Energy efficiency, durability and water management, indoor air quality, green product selection, reduce material use and recycle waste, work with other trades, homeowner education and training manual. Now, let us study the types of carpenter. First, a carpenter and a joiner. It is one who has much broader skill ranging from joinery, finishing carpentry, building construction and formwork. Second, a trim carpenter. It specializes in molding and trim such as door, baseboard and other types of ornamental work. Cabinet installer may also be referred to as a trim carpenter. Third, a cabinet maker. It is a carpenter who does fine and detailed work specializing in the making of cabinet made from wood, wardrobes, dressers, storage chests and other furniture designed for storage. Fourth, a ship carpenter. It specializes in shipbuilding, maintenance, repair technique. A ship carpenter specially for making emergency repair in case of storm damage. To become a carpenter or joiner, you will need to have manual capability, the ability to use proper lifting techniques, the ability to solve arithmetic problem quickly and accurately, and the ability to get along well with others on a work team, good practical skills, an organized approach towards work, the ability to follow technical drawings and plans, good math skills for measuring and working out angles, the ability to work as a part of a team and unsupervised, and awareness of health and safety. In this session, we covered the meaning, types of carpentry, and what are the tools used in carpentry. Thank you. See you in the next lecture.